Pay attention to this form. When I check the checkbox, a new field appears dynamically. And this is what I'm going to be teaching you how to build today, using React, React Hook Form, and Zod. Let's get right into it. If you want to follow along with me, you can clone this repository from my GitHub. The link is in the description. What I'm going to say next doesn't just apply to this form, but to any form you are going to build with React. Always start with the validation first. It is by far the most important thing about your form. And everything else that we're going to build is going to be based on that validation. Let's get started by importing the required libraries. We have Zed from Zod, UseForm from React Hook Form, and ZodResolver from Hook Form Resolvers. As I said earlier, we're going to start by building the validation first. But with this form, we have two kinds of validation, so pay a lot of attention. We're going to start building a schema by making it an object and giving it the field name, which is a string, and sent to email, which is going to be false. Our second schema is going to be called email schema. As like the first one, it's going to have a field called name, which is going to be a string. But the sent to email is going to be true instead of false. And we're going to have a third field, email, which is going to be the email. Now there's one big problem. How do we tell our form which of these validations it's going to use? Thankfully, Zod makes this easy for us by providing a discriminated union validator. Let me show you how it works. Let's define our form schema as discriminated union. And we're going to be using the key sent to email as the discriminator. Next, we're going to give it an array of the types that we're going to discriminate between. And we're going to give the no email schema and the email schema as the types. So how this works is, based on the value on sent to email, it's going to choose either no email schema or email schema. Let's finish building a schema by inferring a type from it. And if I hover over this type, we can see the TypeScript correctly inferred it. It can be either name string sent to email false or name string sent to email true and email string. Now let's plug in this schema to our React hook form. Let's get started by using the custom hook useForm from React hook form. UseForm takes an object where we can give some options, like what resolver we want to use. And we want to use the Zod resolver, and we want to use our form schema as the validation. Now we're going to take register from useForm. But if I hover over the register, we can see that the type is not very accurate. Thankfully, the useForm function is a generic function, so we can extend it with the type of our schema. Now when I hover over the register, we can see that the type is super accurate to our form. And what this register allows us to do is register our inputs into the form. So let's do that next. I'm going to scroll down to our name input, and I'm going to register name. And for a checkbox, I'm going to register sent to email. And for our email field, I'm going to register email. We're going to also take watch from useForm. Watch allows us to, well, watch what the form state is. So at the bottom of the form, I'm going to put some pre-tags and JSON stringify the return of the watch function. And if I save it, we can see that it's correctly showing in the form. So whenever I change the values here, we can see that it's changing correctly in the state. But the dynamic field is not working. The email is showing always, not depending on if it checked or not checked. So let's work on that one next. To check if the checkbox is checked, we need to watch its value. And we're going to use the watch function for that one too. So I'm going to scroll back up top. And we're going to use the watch to watch only the field sent to email. And we can see that the value is going to be Boolean. I'm going to copy this value and scroll down where we have our email input. And I'm going to be conditionally rendering the field if sent to email is going to be true. I'm going to save the form and I'm going to refresh our app. Let's check it out if it works. I'm going to send our name here and I'm going to click on the checkbox. And yeah, we can see that our email field is up here. But take a look at this. Whenever I uncheck the email field still stays in the form, making our form state invalid, as the sent to email is false, but the email exists. This is exactly what we don't want to happen. Thankfully, there's a quick solution for this. Look at this register email here. We can also give it some additional options. Let's give it the options, and the option we wanna check is should unregister true. What this means is whenever we unrender this component, it's also going to unregister it from the state. I'm gonna refresh the app and let's see if it works. Name is working, the checkbox is working, and whenever we uncheck it, we can see that the email field disappears from here. So it's working correctly. How cool is that? Now what we need to work on is handling submitting the form. So from the use form, we're gonna grab handle submit. This special function is gonna, well, handle submitting the form. So let's create a function that does that. We're gonna call it onSubmit. And it's going to take the validated data of the form. If I hover over the type, we don't have any type on it. Thankfully, React hook form gives us the submit handler type, which is a generic type, so we can extend it with the type of our schema. Now when I hover over the data, we can see that the data is correct. I'm going to add some if statement, and if the data has the sent to email true, and we log it in the console, we can see that the email is also going to be string. Else, the data is not going to have the email. So you are never going to send an email to an undefined address. I'm sure you have had one of those errors. And at last, I'm going to add to our form tags on submit handler, which is going to take handle submit, and on submit from our form. Let's save it, open up the console, and see if the form works. I'm going to fill my name here, check the checkbox, and enter an email, and let's order the package. And boom, it's get logged into the console. And if I uncheck the send receipt to email and order it, we can see it works correctly too. How cool is that? I mean, that wasn't too difficult, right? The reason why I'm making these tutorials is not to teach you how to build this exact form, but to teach you the techniques and strategies that you can use to build any kind of application that you want to build. So just to recap what we learned, when building a form, always start with the validation schema. All of your other business logic is always going to come back to that validation schema. It is the most important thing. Let me know in the comments if you learned anything new from this video. I definitely did. And if you liked it, leave a like on the video. And I see you next time.